Welcome to Rslash. Today's video is a little different. We put together a compilation of short stories dedicated to Karens. As usual, the original Reddit post links will be in the description below. Let's get started. Our first story is called Restaurant Karen, posted by Throwaway. Today I was at BK, eating my meal as usual with my family, while still respecting social distancing and all the other health rules. This particular BK is often full of families with small children. They have a dedicated play area, but today it was full. We were all eating and drinking normally, children were talking and playing, and the employees were doing their job well. Then a woman walks in. Let's call her Karen. Karen walks in with an unmuzzled dog on a leash and waits for her turn to order food, while sitting at a table. Karen's dog keeps barking through the whole waiting time. He keeps barking at children playing on the other side of the room, more than 5 meters away from him. Karen tries to get her dog to stay quiet to no avail. Her dog only barks louder. At this point, everyone is getting slightly annoyed. But we all keep eating our meal, trying to ignore Karen and her dog as best as possible. Everything keeps going on normally. Then a kid, let's call him Mark, runs through the tables unexpectedly while playing chase with some other kids. He gets closer to Karen's dog, but is still at 2 meters distance. The dog lunges to attack, but he's stopped because Karen was keeping him on a leash. Mark runs away in fear. Karen then gets really riled up. How dare Mark disturb her furry angel by simply behaving like a typical kid? Karen then sees Mark's mother, let's call her Sandy, and starts picking her argument. Karen insults Sandy for letting Mark run toward her dog and upsetting him. Karen then added insult to injury by saying that Mark had poor manners and shouldn't approach her precious dog like that, who would have behaved just fine if it weren't for Sandy's uneducated, ignorant kid. Sandy replied by saying that Karen was the problem, because she brought an aggressive, unpredictable, unmuzzled dog into a restaurant full of children. Karen then starts insulting Sandy, saying she can't educate Mark properly, calling her all sorts of names while her dog barks even louder, along with Karen's shouts and screams. The whole scene looked like a petty argument out of Jersey Shore. Sandy argues back by saying Karen is the uneducated one because she can't even be responsible for her dog's behavior, and she should have kept him in her car. Mind you, Karen only waited for 15 minutes or so, and she could have easily put the dog back in the car for a few minutes. The parking lot was only a few steps away from the entrance. Then the staff intervene, they have had enough. Karen is advised to leave because her dog is being dangerous to the customers, and she is causing an unnecessary commotion, making it hard for everyone to enjoy their meals. Karen storms off with a look of self-righteous anger, looking satisfied with her own newfound fame, thinking she totally won the argument. Everyone talked behind her back for a while, and then things went back to normal. Everyone did agree on one thing. They never wanted to see Karen or her dog ever again. I understand wanting to keep your pets with you, but this Karen was just being irresponsible with her dog and her uncontrollable attitude. This next story is called The Day I Met Karen, posted by Sango88. So this literally just happened to me 30 minutes ago. My family and I are still laughing. Today I had to go to the store for a few necessities. I went to a U-scan since it didn't have many people. When I first started scanning, I noticed Karen but didn't think much about her, since it just looked like she was looking at some candy that was being displayed. I scan another item, and in the time it takes me to scan it and put the item in a bag, I look back to get my purse and pay, and there she is. Karen is standing so close to my cart it is brushing up on her stomach. Our conversation goes like this. Oh, am I in the way? I ask as I move my cart over. I am nervous because she is not 6 foot away but luckily had a mask on. She replied, sorry, I don't mean to be a mom about it, but you really shouldn't keep your purse open and in the cart. Someone could just come by and take it. I am already paranoid about my purse at stores, so I use the seatbelt for the kid's seat to secure it to the cart. I told her, yes, that is why I lock my purse in with the seatbelt. But people could just go by and reach in. As she is talking, she starts to stick her hand in my purse. Immediately I grab the sides of my purse and close it around her hand. It's just a zipper that I didn't zip up to close. I just held the sides together, if that made sense. No Karens were harmed. Wow, you are making me wildly uncomfortable and you need to go. I made sure to talk louder than normal so it would attract attention in case I needed help. And I grabbed my purse. She pulled back her hand quickly as I grabbed it, and she went back over to her husband or boyfriend that was using another scanner, and left me alone. Right after that, the employee working at the U-scan walked past and caught my eye and asked, hi, did you have a question? No, but please keep an eye on that lady. She just tried to take something from my purse, I said, and then turned back to finish my purchase. When I left, I made a point of keeping my purse on my side opposite of her and left the store. I couldn't believe what just happened, so once I loaded my groceries in the trunk, I called one of my sisters and told her what happened. As I'm explaining the story, I noticed Karen come out with her man holding hands, and she looks at me. I noticed they were coming towards my car, so I hit the lock button just in case, but she passed by and tried to look anywhere but at my car. I get that some people just try to help, but there is a way to go about it, and that most certainly was not it. This would be my first Karen experience, so I'm not sure if I overreacted, but I was honestly just so uncomfortable that it was more a reflex than anything. Let me know what you guys think. Edit. I should also point out that I'm a 27-year-old female. I am not sure why she felt the need to be a mom about it. Wow. This woman was so entitled, she felt she could go up to a complete stranger and stick her hand inside of her purse. Some people never cease to amaze me. Our next story is called Karen is a Nurse, So She Can Do What She Wants. Posted by DJB1983 Convoy. I was sitting in a car in a park the other day. Suddenly there's a dog next to me, trying to sniff my bag. I push it away with my foot. Then Karen runs by and I say, I don't appreciate your dogs being so close to me, you should put your dogs on a leash. Her other dog came up to me as I was saying this. Karen responds, I'm a frontline nurse, you don't know what you're talking about. Then she keeps running by. Karen comes back an hour later with her dogs on a leash. I say, thank you for putting your dogs on a leash, I am sorry I was rude earlier. Her response shocked me. How dare you be angry at me? I am a nurse, you should be thanking me for my service. I told her. Karen, I don't care if you're a nurse, I'm talking about your dogs. She left. I have mixed feelings about this story. Enter your thoughts in the comments below. The next story is called How to Trick a Karen. Posted by Jenin9282. Okay, so I am 13 years old, and I was about to go on a camping trip with my dad and a few of my friends. It was so we could just hang out. While I am at the store getting stuff like beef jerky and supplies, I run into Karen. She was a typical Karen, short blonde hair, short strap purse and overkill shoes and clothes in a small market. Now mind you, even though I am only 13, I'm also 5'10", so it makes sense she might mistake my age. Karen walks up to me and instantly, without any hesitation, says, "Get out of my way, you are blocking this section." At first I didn't think much of it because she was right, I was accidentally in the way, even though it was a little rude. So I said, I'm sorry ma'am. Instantly she says, who taught you those manners? You should respect your elders. Now tell me where I can find product she wanted. I'm kind of ticked off, but still calm on the outside. I say, sorry I don't work here, but product can be found. She interrupts me and says, I know you are lying you insolent brat. Now where do I find product? Where are your manners? I can see my friends in the distance, they are realizing what's going on. They of course want to see what's going to happen next. I told Karen, I was in the process of telling you where product is, until you interrupted me, Mrs. Manners. I was so ticked off at this point I didn't care about being polite. Then I had a genius idea, not really genius but funny. Before she could say anything, I said, in my calmest voice, you know what ma'am, I am so sorry I don't know what came over me, you can find product through the back door in the second room. She said something, I can't remember what it was, but I am sure it was something rude. She then goes to the back door, takes one step outside, because there was no room through the door, and I shut the door behind her. My friends and I hightail it out of there. Mind you, it was the door to the outside parking lot, so she would have had to circle all the way around the building to get back. By then me and my friends were back in the car, in which my dad was waiting without the slightest clue of what happened. Good job OP. Your quick thinking made for a satisfying turn of events. Our last story is, there's not enough ibuprofen for the Karen I ran into today. Posted by Sabuna Sef. I had to stop at the Dollar Tree because my sunglasses broke. I don't pay more than a dollar for my glasses because I'm admittedly a cheapskate like that. As I'm walking out, this lady just walks right in without wearing a face mask. I casually say, ma'am, you forgot your mask, as she goes by me. I get outside and almost off the sidewalk and she comes running out. What the hell did you say to me? Did you say something to me? Ma'am, all I said was you forgot your face mask. Well, it's in my purse and I was about to grab it and put it on before you opened your effing mouth. Okay, well since I left my crystal ball at home, I didn't know that. But this whole time you could be putting it on. So put your mask on and go enjoy your shopping. You know what? I bet you're one of those Trump supporters. Excuse me, don't insult me with that crap. Plus he is the one who told people not to wear masks at one point. If you're looking to use something against a person, make sure you know what you're talking about. Quick side note, to anyone who might have been offended by me telling her not to insult me by calling me a Trump supporter. I meant it in the sense of, don't use someone's political views against them. Support who you want, and I'll support who I want. That is our right. I am not saying who I support, because it genuinely doesn't matter. I just didn't want to be misunderstood. Well, you don't work at Dollar Tree, so F off. As she is going inside, still no mask. I think it's done. I say, F-ing Karen's man, to myself, and head towards my car. This particular Karen apparently had super hearing because the door was almost shut behind her when she threw it back open and ran outside after me again. Oh, you're going to wait until I go inside to F-ing say some crap. Christ crazy Karen, I was just complaining to myself about your flock, but if you want me to say something, put your F-ing mask on. The sign on the door says to wear one, before, you enter, or is your ability to read in your purse too? Cue wild Karen scream of indignation as I get in my car with a one-finger salute and leave the crazy behind. OMG. I would pay to see her face after his marvelous comeback, and as he drove away giving her a one-finger salute. That is all the time we have for today. Thank you for watching until the end. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for future videos.